Hi traders, so in the month of May 2021, I gave a buy call, a positional buy call for Piramal Enterprises. So we are on the weekly time frame here. So one of the subscribers did put 100% of his capital and bought Piramal Enterprises delivery based. I think it was in this one candle. So one candle is 1 week. But what happened was, when he saw no movement in the price for the next 3 weeks, he lost his patience and I think he sold all of his stocks in this one particular week, and you can see what kind of move did he miss. So this is what most of the new positional traders face when you're new into the market. So in this video, I'll be talking about position sizing for positional trades. Okay, so if you're new to this positional trading, then probably you have to have a positional sizing. So we'll be talking about that in this one particular video. Okay. So first, let me clear out, there are a lot of doubts regarding positional trades and swing trades. So if you are into swing trading, let me tell you, you are looking to invest in a stock for ranging from days to weeks. So probably I'll start from somewhere in 2 days to probably 7 day or 10 days. So that would be my max 10 or 15 days. That is just 2 weeks. Okay. Probably from days. 2 days to 2 weeks period. But when you're talking about positional trading, that means we are looking for a bigger movement in the market, and that can range from weeks to months. So I'm talking about somewhere from 2 weeks to years it can take, right? So but what I am interested in is short-term positional trading, which you already know. If you go through my Telegram calls, most of the calls that I gave are short-term positional trading. That means from 2 weeks to somewhere in a range of 2 months would be the maximum that I am interested in investing in a stock. So when you are into swing trading, you mostly look into the time frames like hourly or the 4 hour, and when you are in the positional trading, we look in the daily and the weekly time frame. So I mostly give calls in the weekly time frame. Okay, so the problem with positional trading is that you need to have a lot of patience. Like here itself, I identified this stock at somewhere here when it came to a trend line, and there were other parameters like support. I'll just change it. There were other parameters like support. So there were a lot of confluence at this point. So I had to buy this stock somewhere in this candle, and you won't believe I waited for 1.5 months in this stock to gain this one movement. So that is what you have to do in the positional trade. Now the biggest problem with positional trade is that, let's say what people do. So let's say your total capital is 1 lakh rupees. It can be 10,000, it can be 10 lakhs, it doesn't matter. For this example, I have taken the total capital as 1 lakh rupees. So now we believe that the max risk, the maximum risk that you have to take on one trade, right, on any one trade, shouldn't be more than 2% of your capital. Okay, so what does that mean? Like, many people are confused regarding this maximum risk on capital criteria. So one trade means, like, if you are taking a trade on PEL, you should only take that much quantity in which, when your stop loss hits, that minus MTM shouldn't be more than 2000 rupees in this case, because 2% of your capital here would be 2000 rupees. So whenever I take a trade on PEL, I should only take that much quantity in which, when my stop loss hits, the MTM, the negative MTM, shouldn't be more than 2000 rupees. That is negative 2000 rupees. So if it is getting more than 2000 rupees, I would exit this trade here. Okay. So that's what we mean by the 2% criteria. And I think I have used more for this example. People generally take only 1% and 1.5% as the maximum. So for this example, I have taken 2%. That means 2000 is the maximum that I am ready to lose for one trade, just because my capital is 1 lakh rupees. Okay. Just because my capital is 1 lakh. So my 2% criteria is 2000 per trade, which I am ready to lose for risking my money on a single trade. So what I love to do for positional, short-term positional trades, is that I have divided my capital into equal parts, right? Why equal parts? Because there are no let's say there are no higher probability trades in stock market. I believe it's purely a 50% criteria if a price has to go up or down. So that's why you have to divide your capital equally, because you never know which trade will work or which trade won't work, right? Whether it might be PEL or Reliance or Bharti Airtel, you never know which one would work. So you have to equally divide your capital. I have equally divided my capital into 15 parts. But for this example, to make it easy, I'll divide it into 10 parts. That means this 1 lakh capital would be divided into 10 parts. So each part will become 10,000 rupees. So 1 lakh divided by 10, that would be 10,000 rupees. So like this, I have 10 parts of 10,000 rupees so that I can invest in 10 different stocks right now. So for example, let's say like I went to the charts and I found that yes, PEL is consolidating at this point here. So what I did, I just went and took one of my 10 parts, that is 10,000. I invested in PEL. Okay, so now for positional trades, that is we are in the weekly time frame. Okay, so that what is my criteria? I generally keep a stop loss from my entry point. The stop loss is 10% away. So the 10% amount of that particular stock is my stop loss. And I generally take target at 15 to 20%. So my target is around 15 to 20%. So based on market condition, I sometimes exit 15, sometimes I exit 20. And rarely I have exited at 25 or 30%. I don't wait that long. So 15 to 20 is my criteria. And my stop loss is a strict 10% criteria here. So let's say I'm entering here. I'll just zoom it. If I'm exiting, let's say at 1700, let's say I'm entering at 1700. So purely my stop loss would be 10% down from here. That is, let's see. Okay. So as you can see, my stop loss is 10% of PEL, which is almost, let's say 1500 rupees. And my target would be around, let's say 15%. I'll keep it 15%. So that is around 1970. So how much is my entry? My entry is at 1700. So I'm entering PEL with a stop loss of 10%. As you can see, this is a red part. So that is my stop loss, 10% of PEL. So what is my entry? Okay. So what is my entry? My entry price is 1700. Okay. So my entry price is 1700. So how much should be my quantity here? So my quantity should be this divided by 17. Only that much quantity I need to buy. So that would be equals to this divided by 1700 is the price where I'm entering. So 5.882. So probably I am looking to buy around 6 quantities. So I need to buy around 6 quantities of PEL. So I would be only buying 6 quantities of PEL if my capital is 1 lakh rupees. So what will happen? Let's see. If the price would have gone from 1700 to let's say 1500. Okay. From 1700 to 1500. So this time, luckily our price went up, which was a pure probability, right? It could have gone down as well. So let's say if it went down to 1500, so 1700 to around 1700 to 1550, let's say, I think the stop loss is at 1550. Okay. So it is around 150 points. Okay. 150 points. So I would have got a negative 150 points. Correct. I'll just make it bold. Keep it at 22. I'll just insert entire column. Okay, so minus 50. So when I multiply, like on each stock, I'm getting a loss of minus 150. And how many stocks do I own? I own 6 of them. So if I multiply it, this multiplied by the number of stocks. So see, the maximum loss that I will be taking is minus 900 rupees, which is very less than the maximum capital, that maximum risk on my capital, right? So that's why this quantity that you are buying is very important based on your entry point, right? Based on your entry, this quantity is very important. Because let's say if I bought worth of 10,000, let's say 1700, if I buy, let's say calculator, I'll take out calculator, I have 1 lakh rupees, okay, I have 1 lakh rupees, I divide it by 1700 equals to 58. So let's say I bought 58 quantities here. So the moment there is a price going down by 150 points, my total MTM loss would be 8,700. So just think of the amount of this loss with respect to the total capital, which is around 8% or 9%, which is quite more than what you should risk on each trade. So that's why this quantity here, it is very important. If I keep it on 6 or even if I keep it on 7, that doesn't matter, still the loss is inside this maximum risk on capital. So like that, I can trade on other stocks like let's say Reliance and then Bharti Airtel and then stock number 4. So like that, I can invest on 6-7 more stocks, up to 10 stocks, because I have divided my whole capital into different parts and it is not getting stuck in a single stock. Because see, positional is quite tough for people because everybody wants adventure in stock market. Everybody wants movement every day. That doesn't happen in positional. You have to wait probably for months and months for that one move to come. So you need to have that kind of a patience. That's why it's advisable to divide your capital into at least 10 or 15 parts, right? So my favorite is 15 parts. And I would advise you to divide your capital as well into 10 and 15 parts so that you have the flexibility of juggling between the stocks based on chart patterns that you get weekly in the weekly basis, right? So this is what I wanted to explain to you because some of the subscribers did message me that how much money should they allocate in the calls that I give in Telegram. So like even if in the Telegram, if you observe whenever I am closing a call, when you see a stock, you can see here symbol, it is always around 10 to 15. So that means I have always 10 to 15 stocks in my portfolio and I keep changing, juggling between them based on the percentage move. So whenever I see a minus 10 or minus 9% in that stock, I exit from that stock and I keep that money and I reinvest it in some other patterns. So I think this video was useful for you. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any more doubts, do WhatsApp me in my WhatsApp number. So keep learning, keep trading. Bye-bye.